Hello viewers, welcome to Bulls vs BS Trading Academy. I hope you all are making profits from the support and resistance areas given daily. If you are new to our channel, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. You can join the WhatsApp and Telegram groups from the link given in the description box. So today is 31st October 2019 and the level given yesterday was 11926 to 11953. So here it is 11926 to 11963. 953 it is. So these two are the ranges, resistance ranges given yesterday. And we'll see the intraday movement of Nifty today with respect to our ranges. So here is our first 5-minute candle, second, third. Here becomes the first 15-minute candle. And most people tend to trade a breakout after this. So here it becomes our first 15-minute candle. What most people say is, this is the opening range breakout and they feel that Nifty is going to go higher high from this. I mean, Nifty is going to go upside from this level. But many people do not know that there is a resistance zone nearby. So if we just hide our resistance zones, support and demand areas. This is our first 15-minute candle. Here is our range and this is broken. After it is broken, many retailers tend to take a long position over here. Yesterday also it was the same situation. After this was broken, there was a range over here, but many do not know that and tend to buy, tend to sell the market over here. Here also it is the same. After the 15-minute candle is broken, here there is a resistance zone nearby which many do not know and tend to buy the market at this candle. And most of the retailers lose money because of this thing. See, if we just add our zones, we will be knowing in advance where the market would take a turn. Here, exactly over here, market took a turn and came back. So one needs to learn the price action techniques called as bullish, bearish and then neutral candle. Simple thing is, bullish candle will be having a wick at the bottom. A bearish candle will be having a wick at the top. And a neutral candle will be having both upper and lower wicks. So this is how one can easily remember the patterns. So here we can see wick at the top. I'll just zoom it. See, one can see the selling wicks over the top. Wick at the top is an indication of bearish pattern. So here one can see a wick at the top. So 1, 2, 3. Three candles were showing selling. Selling was observed exactly on this candle at the touch of the zone. So this is how one needs to learn price action. Here we can see the entry of the bulls because wick at the bottom. And we can see the price going up. Here it was becoming a neutral candle, both upside and downside wicks. Neutral candle, no bias. Here we can see the entry of bulls with a long shadow. We went up from here. Two candles showed the bearish patterns. 1, 2. So here there was a sign of entry of bears, and also we can see a range formation. So 1, 2, 3. Three candles were trading within the range of this candle. If you can see this, wait. I'll just make it. So within the range of this green candle, 1, 2. Three candles were trading. So this is an indication of a sideways momentum. So here it formed a sideways, and within the sideways there were two selling candles, selling candlestick patterns. So after, if someone has taken a long trade over here because of these buying sentiments, they should have exited over here because of these selling candles and also a range formation. Here also there was a range formation. So 1, 2, let me make a range over here, the high and low. See, here we can see within the high and low of this red candle, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14. So 14 candles into 5-minute time frame. It's more than an hour. Let's measure it. So it becomes around 1 hour 15 minutes. So for 1 hour 15 minutes, it went into a sideways momentum, and then it gave a breakout where most retailers would be trapped. Because of this breakout, they would be taking an uptrade. So here was a good short entry, and here was a cost to cost exiting, or else a small profit. And when it came down, see where the buyers entered the market, exactly at the range, at the zone given predefinedly. So it fell exactly on touching this range, this level, it went up again. So now we can see how buyers and sellers enter the market irrespective of the range breakout and all the fancy indicators and the things. If you check the touch points, so here we got one touch point, another touch point over here, see, and a third touch point. So this is how zones work. And the zones for tomorrow are, if you cannot read the price action, you can go for a 15 minute range breakout, 15 minute candle. On whichever the side the zone breaks, you can directly trade that side. If you cannot trade price action in the 5-minute chart, if you look at in the 15 minutes, see, we have started here, we went up, touched this, came down again, a 15 minute closing from the zone below side. So we could short this side, and we could book profit as soon as the zone gets touched. So the support zones and demand resistance zones for tomorrow are these, as same given yesterday, no more changes now. So please mark it on your charts, and all the best for your trading. Thanks for watching.